In the year 1500, acoustic guitars were very quiet and out of tune. Everyone wanted the instrument to be louder and more reliable. People did not want to lose the beautiful sound because of a problem that could be solved with a few simple improvements. Acoustic hollow body guitars were becoming one of the most used instruments. Not only is this instrument used a lot, but it has been around for over 5,000 years. Near the late 16th century, people started to make improvements by putting thick, low-octave metal strings on the hollow body guitar. Near the late 18th century, Italy made some very important improvements to a guitar quite like today. This guitar had 5 strings, one less than a modern guitar, and had fixed metal frets. A man named Antonio de Torres Hurtado set the standards of a guitar in the 19th century, including the shape, strings, tuning, size, weight, and the materials to construct the guitar. He also attached a metal cylinder to the sound hole, which increased the volume. This cylinder is known as a tourner vase. The guitar made by Antonio is now known as the classical guitar. The 20th century is when all of the main improvements to the modern electric solid body guitar came into place. The well-known company by the name of Gibson was founded in 1902, when Gibson started creating bigger guitars with steel strings, causing the sound to be much louder. In 1922, a company known as Martin created a sturdy, reliable, and adjustable guitar. After all of the improvements, people started to realize the limits of a purely acoustic guitar. In order to make a loud enough instrument for the needs of musicians, it had to be uncomfortably big and heavy, and the tone would be awful. Most people knew what had to be done to fix this problem. The answer was electronic amplification. This was a brand new technology to people, causing them to be timid of trying it with guitars. Eventually, a company called Rickenbacker created the first electric guitar called the frying pan. This guitar had the body of an acoustic guitar, but had magnetic pickups to pick up the sound and play it through an amplifier or speaker. After the frying pan, every guitar company in America started to make guitars with pickups, and has evolved into the solid body guitar. In the next few minutes, I'm going to teach you the basics of the guitar. The first thing I'm going to talk about is called an amplifier. First things first, all you have to do is turn on the amplifier. You can see there's a clean channel and an overdrive channel. The clean channel is basically an acoustic guitar that's just amplified. The overdrive channel is what you use in rock or metal music. The overdrive channel has a gain knob, 3 equalizer knobs, and a volume knob. The gain knob sets how much overdrive is on the sound. The equalizer knobs set the tone of the guitar. And then the volume knob obviously adjusts the volume. The clean channel is basically the same as the overdrive channel, except without gain. Now that we have the amp settings set, I'm going to teach you 2 basic techniques of the guitar. The first rhythm technique I'm going to show you is called arpeggio chords. Arpeggio chords are basically chords that you just play individual notes of. Here's an example of an arpeggio chord. Hammer-ons and pull-offs are also known as slurs. They help to create a smoother sound between notes. It is the equivalent of a saxophone playing a group of notes with one breath and not tonguing each note. or a violin player playing some notes with one bow stroke. That is the way that those instruments slur and get a smoother sound. A hammer-on will evolve two different notes. A note is plucked, then a second note is sounded by slamming or hammering another finger onto the same string at a higher fret. A pull-off is the exact opposite. You pluck a note and then you pull off to a lower fret.